express the following in index form. So the expanded form is this. So when we don't leave it in index form, when I just like spread it all out, that's expanded form. And I want to convert this to index form. All you need to know is how many of each pronumeral or number we have. So here with A, how many A's do we have? 1, 2, 3, 4. So all we need to write is A to the power of 4, because there's 4 lots of A's. That's all we're asked to do. So B, you can tell me the answer, but it's a little bit different because we've got different pronumerals. And make sure, guys, you gather the like terms together. So here, there's A and B. So how many A's? There's 1, 2, 3 A's. And B, there's 1, 2 B's. So it's gonna be A cubed times B squared. Okay, now you can write this as A cubed times B squared, but you don't really need the multiplication sign there, because if there's nothing in between, it simply means multiply. So, you can write it like that, but it's probably more simpler to write it like this. Okay, so this is that's what it means. So 3 lots of A's, 2 lots of B's. See? Okay, so see how we're doing A times B plus A times B times A. So if we have plus or minus in between, you only look at where it multiplies. Don't do anything with the addition. So, well, as long as they're like terms, you can add it up. But here, I'm just using brackets just to divide these up, just so you don't get confused. So what's A times B? A times B is just AB. And here there's 2 lots of A's and 1 B, so it's gonna be A squared B, because there's 2 lots of A's and 1 B. And we simply add them up, but we can't add them up because they're not like terms, yeah? So we leave it like that. That's all we're asked to do, okay?
Think about me if you get confused
with the groupings. Now D, okay, so we have minus and a plus, so all you need to try to simplify are these, where we're multiplying. So with A times B, we've got 1A, 1B. Here we've got 1A and 2Bs, and here we've got 3As. So how do we write it? Do you guys want to try? This is what I've got. A times B is just AB. You don't have to put the multiplication sign there. And there's 2 lots of Bs here and 1A, so it's just going to be A times B squared, or just AB squared. Plus, there's 3 lots of A's, so A cubed, okay, or A to the power of 3. That's what I have to do here. So it's very, very simple.
What you do is just count how many pronumerals you have.
The numbers, trying to put all the numbers out the front. So see how 7 here, we've got 8 here, and we've got 4 here. Just leave them as it is, okay, because they're the only numbers in each part. So again, I'll just like kind of group them. So make sure you don't like merge them, okay? So keep these in the front, keep these in the middle, keep these in the end. Don't try to like merge them together for some reason. You can't do it because they're not like terms. So there's 3 lots of A's, 2 B's, 2 C's. So the first one will be 7A cubed. The second one will be minus 8B squared. The last one will be 4 and C squared. A times A plus A times B minus A times A. I'll just actually show you, you guys should be okay with this now. We've got 2 A's. Got A and B, and we've got 2 A's. Now remember, guys, I said gather your like terms if you do have any. See how A squared and A squared here? They're like terms, so we can gather them. So what's A squared minus A squared? 0. So we actually eliminate these. So we're just left with AB. So AB is the answer. Count how many of each in each part and write it like an index form like this. Okay, so hopefully I don't have to explain that again. And you can see here, 3a squared and 2a squared are like terms, so we actually can group them together. So 3a squared plus 2a squared is? Well, a squared is a like term, so you're gonna add up your numbers in front, which is gonna be 5a squared plus the remaining number a squared plus b, a squared b. Okay, and that's pretty much it. I just gathered the like terms again. Kind of, guys, just write these in index form. So there's 2 A's here, 2 A's here, and 2 A's here. So you should have 3 A squared minus 7 A squared plus 2 A squared. What can you see, guys? they are all like terms because they all end in a squared. So we can gather them all together. So now you just need to worry about the numbers. What's 3 minus 7 plus 2? 3 minus 7 plus 2 is minus 2, so, or negative 2. Negative 2 a squared. Okay?